Welcome to section two of carbohydrates on digestion and absorption. We're going to start by taking a look at what happens when we eat certain types of carbohydrates. We'll start with my example of a bagel. And I'm choosing a bagel because bagels have a lot of starch. They're highly refined and they're mostly starch, so they do break down very quickly. We think about the starch and how it's a string of sugar units or glucose units. Now, starch digestion actually starts in the mouth. And you can test this yourself by taking something like a highly refined bagel, white bagel, or something as simple as a saltine that's mostly starch, and put it into your mouth and just chew. And instead of swallowing right away, just continue to chew. It'll become a little bit like a paste, but you'll experience a taste sensation which goes from more of a bland starchiness to a little bit of a sugar or sweet taste. And that is the initial phases of the starch digestion happening. Now, once it becomes that paste, you know, it goes down the esophagus to the stomach. There's really little to no carbohydrate digestion happening in the stomach. The main digestion happens within the intestines. So within the intestines, the starch is then broken down into a string of glucose chains. Remember, these are just individual glucose here, and then into maltose. Maltose is a disaccharide. Once it goes into maltose, it'll then be broken down into glucose. So this is our single sugar unit. Now, what about if we took a piece of candy? And the reason I'm mentioning candy is because candy is made of sucrose. So we don't have starch. What we have is our glucose and fructose linked together as our disaccharide sucrose. So again, we might have some digestion start in the mouth, but most of the digestion is going to take place in the small intestines. Remember, digestion is the breakdown of food into its individual nutrients. Once it enters the intestines, it can easily be broken down into glucose and fructose, the two monosaccharides or individual sugar units. So let's take a look at milk. And remember, the main carbohydrate in milk is lactose. So we have our disaccharide lactose with glucose and galactose. So when these enter into the intestines, it's going to become the monosaccharides, glucose and galactose. So lactose breaking down into these individual sugar units. So these have all broken down into their individual monosaccharides, individual sugar units within the intestines. So this represents the intestines over here. And these are the intestinal cells, and this represents the bloodstream. So as each of these, the glucose and fructose and galactose, the monosaccharides, they've already been broken down from the carbohydrate foods that they have come from. They then cross through the intestinal cells into the bloodstream. And now they can go throughout the bloodstream. So within the bloodstream, I do want to point out that most of the cells in the bodies can use glucose. And so cells can pick up glucose and immediately use that for energy. That's why cells want glucose, is they want that form of energy. But the galactose and the fructose have to go to the liver. So for the most part, these are, if they go to the liver is liver does a lot of things, but for our discussion here, the liver is really going to go through the metabolism of carbohydrates. This is where the carbohydrates are metabolized. And as far as fructose and galactose, they are converted to glucose. They also can have other effects or be converted as fat, but for the most part, what I want you to understand is that cells can use glucose for energy. It doesn't have to go to the liver, but if the glucose, fructose, and galactose go to the liver, they can be converted to glucose. In a way, everything ends up as glucose.